The Kirup Pentecostal Empowerment Ministries International of 27 McDonald Street, Kirup, Trinidad, West Indies presents Empowerment Through the Word. Come with us as we affect humanity with the life-transforming power of the Gospel of Jesus Christ. We invite you to stay tuned and be blessed.
Praise the Lord. A pleasant good morning to you again and again. It is such a privilege and an honor to be with you. Hallelujah. What a wonderful God we serve. It's good to be alive. It's good to be living in these times, regardless of what is taking place on the outside. The Lord Jesus Christ gives us a peace that passes all understanding. Thank you for coming again into your homes. What a God we serve. Yes, this program is intended to cause you to trust again, to hope again, to call upon God again, to believe again. Yes, to believe again. Maybe you've been praying and asking God to do something in your life. I am saying to you, don't you give up. Yes, faith in God will bring us the victory. Hallelujah. Remember, the Bible tells us that the kingdom of God is not in word, but in power. The power to cause things to change around us, to behold something that is great, good, and glorious, to bring honor and glory to His name. I want to continue to share on the gospel. The gospel. Jesus said, and I'm reading again, Matthew chapter 24 and verse number 14. And this gospel of the kingdom, this gospel of the kingdom shall be preached in all the world for a witness unto all nations, and then shall the end come. Matthew chapter 24 and verse number 14. Be well aware that every nation will be opened up to receive, to hear. They may not all receive it, but to hear the gospel. And of course, the King, the one who is being exalted, is the Lord Jesus Christ. We touched on the fact that He died for our sins. He was buried, and He rose again the third day from the dead. He is alive and alive forevermore. There is absolutely nothing that we could do against the truth, but for the truth. We went into the fact of the gospel being the good message, evangelion, the Greek, the good message. And what does it state? Well, it is the welcome intelligence of salvation to mankind, as preached by our Lord Jesus and His followers. Let me repeat that again. The welcome intelligence of salvation. You see, the Bible makes it clear in the book of 1 Corinthians, the first chapter, and the 21st verse, that the preaching of the cross is to them that perish foolishness, but unto us who are saved, it is the power of God. It is the power of God. That dunamis, the dynamite of God, God, the ability of God to do exceeding abundantly above all that we can ask or think, according to the power working in us. This morning, if you have never trusted in this power, and the power that comes to us is the Lord Jesus Christ. Colossians chapter 1 and verse number 27, Christ in us, the hope of glory. Do you know Him this morning? I trust that before this program is through, you will certainly surrender to His Lordship. Then, it is the preaching of the preaching recorded by the four evangelists, namely Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. The preaching of the gospel. Matthew 28:19 and 20 reminds us, go ye therefore and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost, teaching them to observe all things whatsoever I have commanded you. And lo, I am with you always, even unto the end of the age. We find out also, it's mentioned in Mark, the 16th chapter, from the 15th verse. Jesus, after his resurrection, declared, go into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. He that believeth and is baptized shall be saved. He that believeth not shall be damned. And these signs shall follow them that believe. In my name, oh, they shall speak with new tongues. In my name, they shall cast out devils. In my name, they shall lay hands on the sick, and they shall recover. I am delighted to let you know that while you and I, we would change because of what is happening, because of the circumstance, because of the environment, because of what people say, God's word is forever settled in heaven. Jesus said to lay hands on the sick and they shall recover. And the Bible continues, and they went forth and preached everywhere, the Lord working with them and confirming the word with signs following. Mark 16 and verse number 20. Then Luke tells us in Luke 24:47, Jesus speaking there, he says, and declared, preach repentance and the forgiveness of sins in my name. In other words, get the word of God out. And we continue to do so. It's an imperative, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, everyone who is named the name of Christ is responsible to get the word of God out. Somebody needs to hear. This word, it is eternal. It is forever settled in heaven. It is incorruptible. And when it's preached under the anointing or shared under the anointing and power of the Holy Spirit, it makes a great difference. John reminds us in John 20 and verse number 21. Jesus said after his resurrection, as my Father had sent me, even so send I you. Are you doing that this morning? We have a tremendous responsibility to get the word of God out. The gospel, the good message, it is a welcome intelligence of salvation. It must be preached. It is about teaching men how to avail themselves of the offer of salvation. Teaching men, we must be taught the things of Almighty God. Jesus said in Matthew chapter 4 and verse number 4, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that comes out from the mouth of Almighty God. Yes, the grace of God that brings salvation hath appeared unto all men, teaching us that denying ungodliness and worldly lust, we should live soberly, righteously, and different, as it were, in this present world. Teaching us. It is the declaring of all the truths, the precepts, the promises, and threatenings that comes with the gospel. Yes, the truth that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of the living God, and that believing on him, we have life through his name. John, the 20th chapter and the 31st verse. It, the precepts, Matthew, the 5th chapter, from the 13th verse, you are the salt of the earth. You are the light of the world, Jesus said, let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify the Father who is in heaven. What a tremendous, what an awesome responsibility given to everyone who is named the name of Christ. Then the promises he has promised us, eternal life, 1 John 2:23. Then he has promised never to leave us nor forsake us. Lo, I am with you always, even unto the end of the age. Matthew 28 and verse number 20. We are also reminded in the book of Hebrews, the 13th chapter, the 5th and 6th verses. Let your conversation or your manner of living be without covetousness, and be content with such things as you have. For he said, I will never leave you nor forsake you. You who are hospitalized and feel no one cares about you. Maybe you have relatives and no one has visited you since. I want to say God has promised never to leave you nor forsake you. In fact, he reminds us in Psalm 91, 15 and 16. He says, I will be with you in trouble. You are suffering at this time. The promises of God are yea and amen. 2 Corinthians chapter 1 and verse number 20. I want to say to you also that through Jesus the Christ, we have the victory. 1 John chapter 5 and verse number 4. Whosoever is born of God overcomes the world. And this is the victory that overcometh the world, even our faith. Jesus said in Mark 1 and verse number 15, repent ye and believe the gospel. Glory be to God. I guarantee you that your life will never be the same again. So it is about the declaration of all the truths, the precepts, the promises, and also the threatenings of the gospel. Here is it. The Bible reminds us in 2 Timothy chapter 3 and verse number 12. Yea, and all that will live godly in Christ Jesus shall suffer persecution. Not only that, in 1 Peter 4 and verse number 16, if anyone suffers as a Christian, don't carry on yourself as it were. You are glorifying God. You're suffering as a Christian, Christ-like. You're allowing the virtues of Christ to flow from your being. Is it easy? No, it's not. But God's grace is sufficient. So the threatenings, and they will come over and over again. Jesus said in Luke chapter 9 and verse number 23, if any man will come after me, let him deny himself, take up his cross daily, and follow me. The gospel, that's right. Hallelujah. So God has promised that this gospel of the kingdom shall be preached in all the world as a witness unto all nations, and then shall the end come. I am reminded that the gospel is called the gospel of grace. Acts chapter 20 and verse number 24, the gospel of grace. The Bible speaks of Jesus going about preaching the gospel of the kingdom of God. The gospel, it is also called the gospel of the kingdom. Matthew chapter 4 and verse number 23, the gospel of the kingdom, the good news of the kingdom. I mentioned some time of God's spell. It's a powerful, positive spell. God's impact, God's influence, God's conviction, the gospel. Then it is also called the gospel of Christ. Romans chapter 1 and verse number 16. The apostle Paul there in his discourse, "For I am not ashamed of the gospel of Christ, for it is the power of God unto salvation to everyone that believeth." The gospel of Christ. The gospel is also referred to as the gospel of peace. Ephesians chapter 6 and verse number 15. "And having your feet shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace." That's right. It is the good news that we bring, and it produces the peace with God, according to Colossians chapter 1 and verse number 20, and the peace of God that comes as the believer will petition God. Philippians 4, 6 and 7. "Be anxious for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known unto God. And the peace of God, which passeth all understanding, shall keep our hearts and our minds through Jesus Christ our Lord." I want to ask you this morning, do you possess that peace? Do you have it in the midst of a troubled world? I want to say to you, I want to publicly declare, you need Jesus. If you do not have that peace, why not surrender to his lordship this morning? The gospel is also called the glorious gospel. 2 Corinthians chapter 4 and verse number 4. "If our gospel be hidden, it is hidden from them that are lost, in whom the God of this world has blinded the minds of those." You see, it is the glorious gospel to shine forth, to make a difference in our lives. Praise be unto God. Then it's also called the gospel of our salvation. Ephesians chapter 1 and verse number 13. The apostle Paul reminds us there. He says, "When you trusted in God, it was so great to understand that you're receiving the gospel of your salvation." This is the fact of the death, burial, resurrection, and ascension of our Lord Jesus Christ. It is also called the everlasting gospel. Revelation chapter 14 and verse number 6. The everlasting gospel. That's right. It must be preached. It will bring the results. If you believe it today, God's word cannot and will not change. He's just looking for hearts who will believe. And if you believe, you will receive Glory be to God. John chapter 1 and verse number 12 reminds us, but as many as receive him, to them he gave the power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name. Will you trust him this morning? Will you surrender to his lordship? He reminds us that if we would confess with our mouths that Jesus Christ is Lord and believe in our hearts that God raised him from the dead, we shall be saved. For with the heart man believeth unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. This morning, do you know him? Maybe you know about him. You have heard about him. But do you know him? It is so important this morning. I want to help you. If you would pray a simple prayer with me right now, say with me, please, oh God, I come to you just as I am. I am a sinner in need of you as my Savior. Jesus, forgive me now of all my sins. Wash me in your precious blood. Come into my life now and save me. I confess you as my Savior and as my Lord. And I believe in my heart that you are alive and alive forevermore. Thank you now for saving me and writing my name in your book of life. Amen. Let me pray for you right now. Father, in Jesus' name, I thank you for those who have prayed that prayer. I pray that you will reveal yourself to them in ways, God, that they certainly will understand that you love them unconditionally. I ask, Lord, that every need will be met in their lives so that they'll be able to lift their hands and give you the praise, the glory, and the honor. Thank you for doing great and mighty things. Oh God, I pray for this land, this blessed land, Trinidad and Tobago. Father, continue to extend your mercy and your grace towards us. I want to thank you for your goodness and your faithfulness towards us as a people. Those who are sick in body, even right now, I speak the word of healing and of deliverance. Be thou made whole from the crown of your head to the soles of your feet. Every need is met in Jesus. Receive and believe it now, because he is Lord. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Well, Trinidad and Tobago, and wherever we are heard, remember, we are not going under. Why? Because Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. The Lord richly bless you. Have a productive week. Please seek to make the difference. Make a difference in the lives of somebody. God bless you. Amen.